Good morning, guys. Today I'm going to do a short video review of an aftermarket fix for a VW Jetta trunk latch defect. I should tell you that I'm completely unassociated with the makers of this device and I've received no compensation from them. About 6 months ago, we noticed the release mechanism to open the trunk from the driver's door was not working. We could hear the power actuator moving when pressing the release button in the driver's door, but the trunk wouldn't open. In my case, I had to crawl through the back seat and open the trunk from the inside so I can get at it. From inside the trunk, I was able to take off this whole panel, and moving this out of the way, I found the hood latch that allowed me to open the hood from the inside. On further review, I found a broken plastic part that the actuator presses on, and I didn't videotape that, mainly because the repair is identical to that shown in the links below. Then I checked all data for TSBs and repair advice, and as far as I could tell, VW just advised replacing the broken part with another part of the same design. A short internet search led to my conclusion that this is a frequent problem with this model car, suggesting that the underlying design was inadequate to support the torsion this part is under. It has always rubbed me the wrong way to replace a defective part with a new part of the same design, since you're inviting recurrent problems to the future. So I searched the problem on YouTube and Google and came up with an aftermarket fix that claims to be better. Links to the videos shown are listed below. I sent away about $50 and the product quickly came to our US address and the part was installed easily. It worked exactly as advertised and overall I'm happy with the result. You could argue that time will tell, but I think this aftermarket fix is actually designed better than the original, and it is certainly designed with the critical point of failure in view. The only disappointment I have is that VW didn't come up with this themselves. Here's an ethical question. How much does a manufacturer owe its customers for the redesign of common points of failure after the product leaves the showroom floor? You know, dealers get early feedback on these vehicles all the time, and so they are in the best position to design a fix. So I think they have some obligation, and anything less speaks to their reputation. I'd be interested in what you guys have to say about that. Thanks for watching.